This is part 2 of the fundamentals of FM synthesis, FM4 and analog synths. Now, we understand the very basics of FM synthesis. We can try emulating sound from our analog synths. Let's try with a soft and warm pad. For analog synths, two sawtooth waves from two oscillators with slow attack and slow release. You can use a filter to cut down on harmonics, making the sound warm and soft. Here is a Minimoog soft pad with Synthronik. Use a detune for second oscillator so that you get a chorusing effect. Select the patch that you made in part 1, and we will use this patch for making pads. Let's try emulating that with FM4. First, we've already created a sawtooth pad with one VCO using operators 3 and 4. By reducing level for operator 4, we can emulate a soft sound. We will reduce it to 5.0. When you press a key, you hear a soft pad sound. We will do the same with operators 1 and 2. Turn off operators 3 and 4 and turn on operators 1 and 2. First, we will change pitch for both operators 1 and 2 to 1.00. Then, select a sine wave for both operators. For an envelope, we will set operator 1 attack to 5.0, decay at minimum, sustain at maximum, and release around 5.0. For operator 2, we will set attack to fastest, decay to 0, sustain to 10, and release to 10. For level, set operator 1 to 10. For operator 2, set level to 5.0. Set LFO and velocity for both operators 1, 2 to 0. Now, we have a similar setting with operators 3 and 4. Turn on operators 3 and 4 and press a key. We have a soft pad, but there is no chorusing effect. We will change pitch for operators 1 and 2 to get the chorusing effect. Make sure to press fine button and reduce pitch for operator 1 and 2 to 0.99. Once completed, press a key and hear sound. Now, we have a soft pad with a chorusing effect. So, this is how you create a soft pad on FM4. Let's summarize what we've done so far. We used the modulator operators 2 and 4, like VCF, to cut down on harmonics. Tower 1 pitch is adjusted slightly to keep the tune so that you get a chorusing effect. One of the advantages with FM synths over analog synths is that for analog synths, when you cut down harmonics using VCF, you also cut down sine wave, so the overall volume is very low when you try to create a soft pad. For FM synths, you can use a sine wave for carrier operator, so you always have a soft and warm pad thanks to the power of a sine wave. Now, we will create a sawtooth pad on FM4. We will use a soft pad, turn off operators 1 and 2. As we need to emulate the filter opening with analog synths, we will increase level of operator 4 to 6.4. Turn off operators 3 and 4 and turn on operators 1 and 2. Let's change level for operator 2. We need to create another sawtooth type sound from tower 1 using operators 1 and 2. Set output level to 6.4. Now, we have a similar setting with operators 3 and 4. Let's press a key and listen to a sound. Well, it is too soft, like a filter is closed, cutting down high harmonics from a sawtooth wave. The reason is that operator 2 does not have a feedback loop, and only a sine wave is used for modulation. So, if you just use a sine wave, you won't get a sawtooth wave. Fortunately, we have other waveforms to choose from. Let's try to find waveforms that generate a sawtooth wave. We can start from a modulator, operator 2. What we look for is a waveform that packs higher harmonics, in this case, buzzy tone, typical of a sawtooth wave. The second one is a cross between sawtooth and square wave, and it doesn't have much higher harmonics. The third one is more like a square wave with packing higher harmonics and a bit buzzy. The fourth one is softer triangle waveform like sound. The fifth one is squarish but lacking higher harmonic tone. The sixth one is a triangle-like waveform, but lacking higher harmonics. The seventh one is squarish, but it has too much unnecessary harmonics, not enough higher harmonics. The eighth, the last one, is squarish and softer than the seventh waveform. So, based on what we hear, we can select the third waveform. Now, let's try selecting a waveform for operator 1 as a carrier. So, we can select a waveform that produces a very similar sound to tower 2 sawtooth wave. The second one is cross, but it has unnecessary sideband. The third one is more like a sawtooth sound, but it seems having too much modulation. The fourth one is a perfect match. The fifth one, although like a sawtooth sound, it produces too much unnecessary harmonics. The sixth one produces a formant-like tone for creating human voice type sound. The seventh one has too much unnecessary harmonics. The eighth, the last one, has too much unnecessary harmonics. So, we will use the fourth waveform for operator 1. Now, turn all operators on. You get a nice sawtooth pad. To fine-tune the sound, you can decrease operator 2 output slightly to 6.2. Now, we have the finely tuned sawtooth pad. So, let's revise what we've learned so far. We created a sawtooth pad by using tower 2, operator 4 to generate a sawtooth wave. For tower 1, instead of a sine wave, we selected appropriate waveforms for operators 1 and 2 to generate a sawtooth wave. We fine-tuned the level for operator 2 and created the nice sawtooth pad with a chorusing effect. So, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. For next tutorial, we will make another DX7 sound on FM4.